Long tail.
Cheddar.
Mugen.
Mugen.
Mikey.
Mikey.
Sticks.
Sticks.
Yorel.
Yorel.
Husky.
Lady.
Huh?
Lady.
Lady? I don't think so.
Well,
my God, Kevin.
Husky or a whale on the certificate. Make sure that these go to the right dude.
You guys are
cool. Huge.
Well, we're all from different groups, but it's like an Olympic all-star team, so it's called Scarlette.
Yeah. We are Rucker Flexers, a mix of what started us and what it evolved to. Kind of like what the guy that was speaking before us was talking about, the old generation and the new one. We're the leaders of the new generation. We're the people that's coming to teach the people after us. Some of us have been dancing for longer than others, but we've all been around what we're understanding. And we wanted to bring this to you guys so you can understand what we go through, but he's talking about what you're talking about, what everybody here is presenting for today. Everyone can know that there are people actively trying to be together at all times.
Yeah.
Don't stop. You know, that's what Scarlett's for.
Yes, sir.
I'm incredibly athletic, but how do you dislocate your shoulder?
I had to hurt myself. That's the short answer.
I stretched.
Oh, I was not like this.
So did you all originate this?
No.
No.
Where did this originate?
I mean, like with any genre and any medium, it's hard to say where it actually started from, but I would just personally like to think people like Brooke, people in Flex in Brooklyn, our older generation, our culture, and Sticks, he can expand on it as well.
The history of it, where it all originated, as he said, Brooke. His name is George Brooke Adams. The style originated in Jamaica. And he came to New York, ran into a couple of artists, Busta Rhymes, and Missy Elliott during the 90s, and the culture spread from Jamaica into the States, and people in Brooklyn was doing it in the 90s in lockdown parties, clubs, anyway, just getting going, just because that's the overall term of Brooklyn. It's breaking up your limbs. You understand? So flexing, it evolved from that. It just has concepts in it, such as connecting and home breaking, which is also part of Brooke, because that was one of his signatures that he used to do. He used to home breaking, kill the party, start. But yeah, it's so much, because like you said, we can't really trace it back. So us being the young leaders, we're correcting our mistakes. So it's a lot on our shoulders, because I've been doing this in this culture for 10 years, and I've been through the roughest. So collecting all the knowledge, going to the forefathers of the style, and then going to the other side of the culture, which is Brooklyn, because it's separated in New York.
But you have flexing
and
you
have Brooklyn.
Yeah.
They're both the same.
But they're both the same because it's language you speak.
We all speak the same language. We all have different dialects.
Yeah.
And we speak through our dancing. And at times it becomes a war zone, and it hurts everyone involved, the younger generation and the older too. Because the older don't feel like they can come back home, and the people who left that went away to spread the culture don't feel like they come back home. And the younger generation, some of them don't want them back home when they're putting out for us, and we're fighting a war here. our dancing is speaks volumes. But we all have to go through it too.
I hate to do this, guys, because you're so amazing. We only have time for one more question, so I want to reiterate that we're all going to be hanging out at the center. I don't know how old everybody is, but I'm working here. I don't know.
Yeah, you? Yeah, right
there.
Yes, I wonder, you, each one of you has your own choreography?
Honestly, that was all freestyle. That was all improvised.
Martial art training, like a young man to the back with a tent,
you got a tall guy. Well, actually, no.
No.
I have inspiration from martial arts, but I never took martial arts.
Can we give them all a huge